Wisconsin Republican Governor Scott Walker tonight survived a historic recall sparked by his effort to strip union rights from public employees, an issue also fought in Ohio.
There were actually several recalls on the ballot tonight, but the governor's race has potential implications for the fall presidential contest. ABC's Karen Travers looks at what happened in Wisconsin in this Democracy 2012 report.
Scott Walker scored a big win, and he'll get to keep his job. Voters in Wisconsin decided to stick with their Republican governor instead of voting in Democratic opponent Milwaukee Mayor Tom Barrett. Today's vote caps a contentious 17 months in office for Walker. Last year, the Republican governor fired up teachers and state workers when he successfully stripped away their bargaining rights in order to balance the state budget. That led to the fierce battle to remove him from office. But Walker can point to results. Last year's $3.6 billion budget deficit, a state record, has turned into a slight budget surplus. And that's all from cuts, no tax increases. It was a costly fight. $60 million was spent on the recall campaign, most of it from outside the state. The White House dismissed suggestions that the recall race has implications for the presidential race.
A race where one side is outspending the other by a ratio of at least 8-1, probably won't tell us much about a future race.
But the Romney campaign said a Walker win could put the state in play for them. The presumptive Republican nominee has his work cut out for him. According to exit polls, today Wisconsin voters favored the president by a 6-point margin over Romney. Karen Travers, ABC News, Washington.